Finally, one more thought. Getting more bees with honey than with vinegar, especially if they're rich bees. This week saw a lot of talk about taxing the rich in the United States, whether they're companies.
That at least 55 of our largest corporations use the various loopholes to pay zero federal tax income tax in 2020.
Or they are people.
Moving capital gains taxes up is a big deal, right? That, in essence, is a wealth tax.
New York State is doing more than just talking about it. After Governor Cuomo last year pleaded with the rich to stay in New York.
And I say, you got to come back. When are you coming back? We'll go to dinner. I'll buy you a drink. Come over. I'll cook.
This week, the New York governor agreed to a budget slapping big new taxes on those making over $1 million. Taxes that could raise the marginal rate for the richest New Yorkers up over 52%. Only time is going to tell whether the state's 90 billionaires or 30,000 millionaires vote with their feet because of all these new taxes. But we are already seeing what using a bit of honey instead may mean, as the Chinese government plans new tax breaks on the wealthy in Hong Kong, seeking to make up for all those violent demonstrations and the political crackdown, with the result that investment managers have set up more than 100 new companies in recent months, and banks like Goldman Sachs, Citigroup, Bank of America and Morgan Stanley are ramping up their staffing over there. None of which is to say that those of us who have benefited from the boom markets shouldn't pay our fair share, much less that we want to trade off civil liberties for tax breaks. But we do have to hope that the people making decisions keep in mind that pesky law of unintended consequences.